Welcome to Minity Maths. In this video we will go through how to solve a quadratic equation using the quadratic formula. If you need a refresher on the topic, watch our introduction to quadratic equations, linked above and in the description below. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos. Here is the quadratic formula. This formula can find the solutions to any quadratic equation. You are usually provided with this formula on GCSE exam papers, so knowing how to use it is extremely important. The quadratic formula is handy to use when factorization isn't possible or isn't obvious to you. It is also useful if you need your answers in decimal form, fractions or surds. Exam questions may also specify that you use this formula, rather than any of the other methods. Let's have a look at the formula in more detail. Firstly, we are given some variables, x, a, b, and c. The x value represents the solution, or solutions to the quadratic equation. This is the answer we are trying to find out. The values a, b, and c represent the values in the standard form for a quadratic equation. As a reminder, here is the standard form of a quadratic. We can now match these values to the ones in the quadratic formula. You may be wondering what this plus and minus notation here means. This means that when calculating the square root we need to apply the positive and the negative value. We are essentially using two formulas, one using the positive square root, and one using the negative square root. For a refresher on square roots, see our video linked above. This part of the quadratic formula under the square root sign is called the discriminant, and it can tell us how many solutions the equation has. If the discriminant calculates to a positive number, there will be two solutions, if it is zero there will only be one solution, and if it is negative there will be no real solutions, only solutions using imaginary numbers, but this won't usually be covered at GCSE level. Let's have a look at an example question. We will keep the standard form for quadratic equations on the screen to refer to. The equation in the question is already in the standard form, so we don't need to rearrange anything. Let's first identify the values for a, b, and c, from the equation. Here, a, equals 1, as there is no coefficient for x squared written in the equation. B equals 5. And c equals 6. Now let's substitute these values into the quadratic formula. For a refresher on substitution, see our video linked above or in the description below. We replace a with 1. B with 5, and C with 6. Now let's simplify the equation. We can calculate 5 squared, as well as perform the multiplications. Now, inside the square root we can take away 24 from 25, leaving us with the square root of 1. This is where we now concentrate on the plus and minus notation of the square root. We write two calculations out, one with a positive sign outside of the square root, and one with a negative sign. Now we can calculate the two solutions. So x is equal to minus 2 or minus 3. To check your answer you can put your values for x back into the original quadratic equation to check it matches. Now let's look at a slightly more complex question and follow the same steps we just did. Let's identify the terms. Notice that we have two negatives here, minus 7 and minus 1, make sure to include the minus signs when making a note of the values and substituting them in. Now let's substitute these values into the quadratic formula. Next let's simplify the equation by working through the multiplications. When squaring b in this instance we are squaring the minus 7 not just the 7. Again here, we are left with 49 take away minus 12. The sign rules tell us that two minuses make a positive, so we can change this. Now we simplify further and perform the two calculations. The square root of 61 is a decimal number, in our workings out we have only written part of the decimal, however, when using a calculator, it is best not to round any numbers until the very end to ensure accuracy. Have a go at these practice questions and pause the video while you work them out. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to Minity Maths for weekly videos.